True Gamer here, and I'm back with another Retro Circle episode. Now, as you see in front of me, it's finally arrived, fresh out of Japan. And for those whippersnappers who don't know what this is the legendary Mega CD. Now, this console slash add-on is up there with the Neo Geo and Super Famicoms of the world, and it's definitely one of my personal favorite consoles of all time. Fortunately, the box is a little chewed up. So look at that. Turn it over, it's on its last legs. I've got to look on the bright side. At least I've got the official inlays and inserts, and seems I've got half of the system manuals. But yeah, not good enough. I might have to go searching for some manuals there. Yeah, this is like a metal plate that sits on top of your Mega CD. And this is for if you've got the Mark II or Mark III versions. Now, this is the Mark I, and it's the Japanese version. They've made three models of this Mega CD, but the Mark I is the rarest, it's the most rarest one to find out there in the gaming hunting world. So it comes with a AC mains adapter, and it's the same one that they use in the normal Mega Drive slash Genesis. And you've got an RGB SCART cable, but that's my personal own. So as I stated before, guys, to get this running, you're going to need your standard Mega Drive, because simply without this, the Mega CD will not run. And to attach it, you're going to have to open this expansion port by removing this cover, like so. And then you kind of slide it in. Now, as I mentioned before, we have this metal plate here, but that's only for the Mark IIs and the Mark III versions of the Mega Drive. If you've got the Mark I like I have, you will not need the plate. And it should just slide in. Like so. So this is how it will look, guys, when it's connected up correctly. Now, this is basically a peripheral rather than a console, to be fair, but it still cost a lot of money way back in 1991, and that's when it was released in 1991. But even to this day now, in 2021, it's worth a fortune, especially the Japanese Mark I models of this. Now, you can also add a 32X machine to this via this Mega Drive cartridge slot port, and you can turn it into the Tower of Power. Now, the Tower of Power is what most retro gamers would call it when it's all hooked up with the 32X. Unfortunately, I don't have a 32X, but I can show you some pictures on my screen, and this is what it will look like. Okay, let me show you the ports, and it's only got four ports on the back. You do need a separate power adapter in order to get this up and running, which is a bit of a pain, probably because they wanted to add more useless clutter to your wire management on the back there. But yeah, I'm gonna start from the left and go to the right. Right here is where the power adapter would be. Then you've got the audio in line, which is basically a headphone jack. And then we got these two ports here, and these are the RCA stereo out. So I think I didn't say this in the beginning, you can play CDs on this as well as play games, and also you could hook this up to a stereo, as you see with these inputs there, the white and red. You can hook it up to a stereo, and you can also hook it up to an amp. So yeah, once you've hooked it up to a stereo and amp, it just expands the sound and makes everything come through louder speakers and whatnot. On the front of the Mega CD, as you see, we've got ready, we got access, and I guess they light up considering what commands you tell it to do. And if you're wondering how you get this to work on your TV, the magic happens all through the Mega Drive, because you got to hook up the Mega Drive to your TV, and also, like I say, you need an extra power adapter. Now this takes composite AV video cable, and as I showed you before, you can also use a RGB SCART lead. As for me, guys, I use a wonderful Hyperking HD cable, and what this does, it improves the resolution on my Mega Drive, all my Mega Drive games and the Mega CD games, and it improves it tremendously. It just sharpens all of them distorted pixels at the maximum level. So yeah, if you want to grab one of these, this is called the Hyperking, and it's for the Genesis / Mega Drive. And yeah, you can get these Hyperking cables on eBay or Castlevania Games, or even Limited Run does it. Now let's take a breeze through my modest game collection that I've got so far. As you see, they're all in like bubble wrap, because I need to go and get myself some protective cases, because as you know, these jewel cases are very, very fragile. So you have to, if you haven't got any protective cases, just keep them wrapped up in something which will give it some security from crashing. You can get games for a reasonable price, but the best ones are normally super expensive and just silly money. So as for me, I doubt I'll be getting much games for this machine. I'm a hardware enthusiast. I just like retro machines. That's the thing that intrigues me more. Just looking back at all the different designs that they created throughout the generations, way back in the day. And another thing, this machine, this is a Mega CD / Sega CD. This machine had a lot of full motion video games, along with a lot of classic gems. But the Mega CD, the whole existence of the Mega CD was to enhance the base Mega Drive games to give it like, make it the better version of them, for like better sound quality, enabling rotation and scaling. So if I just break it down, the Mega CD just gives extra special features to games where the original Mega Drive is not capable of. For example, in Sonic CD, there's certain camera angles which is only possible when the Mega CD is connected to your Mega Drive. I'll just leave that as that. Now I'm going to start with my most valuable game, which is this bad boy here, and it's the Adventures of Batman and Robin. Now as you see, the American games are packed with a larger jewel case. It's like a big difference between the Japanese and the European jewel cases. I much prefer the American cases. Yeah, I must prefer the American cases, but it's not practical if you're running out of space and you need to make a little bit of room for other games. So as you see, guys, this comes complete with the manuals. It normally has like a square sponge in between here to make the CD secure, so it will have no chance of slipping out, but I haven't got that bit. Other than that, it's basically complete. As long as it's got the manual, I'm more than happy with that. BBC, in other words, big beautiful cases, and it's not really that cheap to obtain one of these. Next up, I'm going to show you the European jewel cases, which are slightly thicker than the Jap cases, but much smaller than the US versions of the jewel cases. It is the Arcade Classic, and with this it has five games on a disc, and they are these bad boys here. Golden Axe, Super Monaco Grand Prix, and Streets of Rage, Revenge of Shinobi, Columns. And there you have it, packed with goodness. And this comes complete with the manual, as you can see. And if I open the other side here, I'm not too sure. It looks like I need another disc. I don't know, but I've got all the games which were required, so I'm not too sure about that one. Okay, next up we got another European jewel case, and this is 2-in-1. We got Soul Fierce, and we've also got Cobra Command, and this is complete with its instruction manuals, with all of its goodness, and also Cobra Command has the booklet as well. So at the moment we're 100% complete in all my game collection. Now the last two I'm going to show you guys are the Japanese jewel cases, and they are the slimmest of all, and definitely ideal if you're running out of space in your game collection. And this is Final Fight CD, an absolute classic on the machine. Not that expensive, the Japanese version, but the American version, it will cost you quite a bit. And as you see, we are CIB, complete in box. And my last game will definitely be CIB, complete with all of its credentials, because it's a sealed version and it's a sealed Japanese jewel case, and it's Wonder Dog. It's supposed to be a gem, because that's for me. And yeah, I'll probably keep this sealed. I'll try and get a duplicate if I can, because I just don't want to crack the seal for some reason. I know it's a bit crazy, but there you go. That's the life of a collector's mind. Sneak peek. Okay, so now if not complete with all the product manuals, safety and warranty booklets, I know they can be quite a nightmare to get, they at least have to have the manuals. There you go guys, that's a quick unboxing of the Mega CD / Sega CD, and I've showcased all the games that I've got so far. I'll probably get an extra one or two, the rest, if I want to play any of them, I just do it the Rom de la Rom way. But there you have it, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there's two come with that. I've got 6 games so far, I'm kind of pleased with that, but like I say, I'm mostly, all I want is the hardware to own and function. And I'm really just happy with that, and just one or two games, so I know it works. So that's the video, guys. Now, if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. Even better, subscribe. Till next time, see ya.